NerdDice.
Welcome to the Stateless Codecast. This is episode number 40 in our series, Create a RubyGem NerdDice. So we had four kind of after creation of implementation of the die class little follow-up items that I wanted to tackle and add to our backlog. In our last video, we fixed some we did a little bit of refactoring on the die class. We got rid of some put statements that we accidentally left in there and went in and implemented the comparable module in the die class. So now that you can compare and sort your set of dice by the value, and it will give you what you need, which will come in handy once we look at our dice set class. So in this one, we're gonna I'll do these in opposite order. So first we're gonna add a damage type option to the die class. This is gonna be very similar to what we've done before. We'll just add in a couple new specs here. We'll leave value at the bottom, which you can just change the one above it. So by default, set it. So we'll add in another line here. Our damage type will be fire. Let's, these are not default, so let's fix these. Applies the sometimes when you copy and paste, you have nonsensible named specs. So those will both fail. And that third one should have failed. We'll look at that in a minute. So let's make the other ones pass. we'll look at that. Random failure. So I'm let's implement this. So we'll have a, this is another attribute accessor. So we're back to passing, except that we're not really passing because die 3 and die 4 will always be 1, so we don't have to worry about that. All right, I'm going to do this several times just to make sure that I'm accurate here. So it took about 20 more times, but I did get another failure, so I do need to rethink create a method here. We're going to violate the, temporarily violate the line length here, but I want to know only run that line 102. Let's see. Do it with a random object instead. Those are still coming out differently. I need the technique in my method. That was my problem. So hopefully that will solve this. Go back to die spec. Still so if we can go back to our before. That. look at my README. Gotta have the right. No, it's still not behaving the way I would expect it to. This again. That's going to just give me the old seed. Giving me a prior seed. But it is not consistently giving me the same values. Back to our README. Again, failure to pay close attention to the properties. They're always the same, which is what I wanted. Let's see if I can now get rid of these calls to roll. Consistent values. That is what I want. Moral of the story, read your own documentation and provide the correct options. in your options hash. Errors. Good. All right. So that's done. And now we want to go in and change our configuration. So we're going to make these DD instead of FF so that they fail. Got the two failures that we expected. So now let's go in to configuration. And configuration spec. And modify these. And then it lets you set them as well. Thank you. ugly combination to do at the same time, but we're just testing things. So now we've got 6 failures, got no method in our Let's get our defaults working. In configuration, what was our order in? We had those after our accessors. We'll keep that order the same. So do that. And our foreground color. Accessors. That should get us down to 4 failures, which it does. And then by default, our down to 2 failures, and then we just want to go into die, get rid of these 2 constants. Delegate it to configuration, and we're back to passing. So we'll look at RuboCop, make sure we didn't create any new issues for ourselves. It doesn't look like we have. Got damage type and default background. Both of those are implemented. think that puts us in a good situation to commit and push our code. Write our message. So we've got our message. We'll sign it, seal it, deliver it. It's yours. We'll let our build finish. We've got success. Go back to our backlog. Move that to done. Now I'm comfortable moving these two to done. And there we go. And in our next episode, we'll start taking a look at the dice set. Thanks for watching this Stateless Codecast. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and spread the word. You can follow us on social media at Stateless Code. Until next time, keep coding, and don't aggress against peaceful people or vote for others to do so on your behalf.